Hello. In this video, I will be explaining how as a parent you can use parent portal and mobile app for Azan Bin Kaya school. So to start with, I will open a school website. So I have opened a browser. A parent can log into any updated browser, for example, Google Chrome, Firefox or Edge. So to start with, I am entering a school website, which is azanbinkayas.com. When you open a website, you can scroll down and there is an option given for parent portal. So when you click on parent portal, it will redirect you to the new page. Please ensure in your browser the pop-ups are not blocked. In case the pop-up is blocked, it will give an indication somewhere here and you can unblock that particular site. Now to start with, I have taken one parent ID. So for example, I am logging in with one parent ID and the password, and I click on login. When I click on login, this is the first page which I will see when I log in. Now as a parent, I can see there are multiple students for this particular parent. So when you open that, it shows you the all detail of the children. You have option to minimize this dashboard. Again, you can minimize, so this is how it will look. According to the screen size, if you are opening in a tablet or in a laptop, it will adjust the screen automatically. So what are the features we are looking at here? So by default, you can see the student which is you are seeing an information is for Miss Hala. If I click on another student, Marwan, then it will show the details. So let's go and see what are the features available here. So you can see in the dashboard, there are two dashboards available, one for an attendance, one for a circular. So if I click for an attendance, so now it is going to show me attendance for Marwan. So it shows me his present, late, absent, etc. and the summary of that particular month. You will be able to navigate back in previous month like this. To go back to a dashboard, you can click on this particular icon on left hand side top and it will bring you back on the dashboard. So you have another dashboard here as a circular detail. If you click on it, it will show you all the circular which are available there. If you click on circular as an acknowledge, it will acknowledge that circular and it will bring the circular on the top which is unread or not acknowledged. So by default, it is going to show you all the circulars, but you do have an option to search a circular particular date from and to, or you can have an option to search it with an content of that particular circular. As a parent, you will be able to use this app or the portal in Arabic language as well. So if you click on Arabic, it will change the orientation of the page as well as the content of the page into Arabic. In case the school has entered the content in English, it will show in English, whereas all the headings or the text will show it in Arabic. Let me convert back it in English to explain the other features. So if you click on the menu, you can see these are all the features available for parents to access. As I will just go through quickly. So student profile, where you can see the student details, then the attendance of the student, assignment, this is nothing but the homework or anything which is given to a student, then the teachers which are teaching with their subject, the medical information of the child. Parent will be able to edit these details as well if they are authorized to. Here you can see the medical visits of the child. If the child is visiting a nurse, it will be reflected here. Then the news, which are the newsletters which are published. If you click on the attachment, it will show that attachment in the new file. You can go back to the main page. Then we got a calendar, school calendar. So it will show all the related information of the events or the activity which are happening. The photo gallery, what are the activities which are happening and what are the photos there. Parent can click on the photos and it will expand and you will be able to see as a slideshow as well. Then we have circulars. You can see the circulars. Then the reference and handbooks. Parent profile. the parent will be able to even update the information on this screen in case of any thing to be changed like a mobile number or anything. And the library transaction, if the student has been issued with some books and in library, then school Facebook account and Twitter account. So these are the features which are available for parent to access it. So every parent should have only one ID, and the parent, he or she, should be able to access all student detail from the same ID. Now, next step, I am going to take you through a mobile app. Now you can see I have connected to the mobile now. So to start with, you can go to a Play Store or an App Store in your mobile and download an app with the school name. So if I go here and search for Azan bin Qais, you can see a mobile app which is Azan bin Qais International School, and it is published by BMS Solutions LLC Dubai. So I have already installed this, so I will click on open. So when I click on open, you will have to log in with the same parent ID and password which I have used to log in the web. So I am going to log in here. This is the login page which is showing. So I will just log in with the parent ID which is there and the password. So I have entered the password and I'll click on login. So when I click on login, this is the login page in mobile app which you will see. Now this is similar to an portal which you have seen in the web. You can see the dashboard. Now the new thing in mobile app, you have notifications. So we have a very good feature which is a push notification in case of any communication which is related to student activities in school or a communication from teacher will be shown here. So you can see it shows communication from teacher. If I click on this unread one, it shows what is the communication. And if once you read that, the it turns into the read, and the teacher will also be able to know what is the status, whether the message sent by him or her have seen by a particular parent. Now when I click on a menu here on right and left hand side top, you can see there is an option for English and Arabic. So if I wish to open this mobile app in Arabic, I'll be able to click in as an Arabic, and I can see all the menus in Arabic language. Let me turn back in English. So these are the features which we saw it in parent portal. Same features are available here. So to see a particular child detail, you can see currently this is for a first child. If I click on the another child photo, it will show me the detail related to that particular child. So if I am checking the attendance now, it is showing me the attendance for the child which I have selected. So very important feature for parent. On right hand side top, you can see there is an option of communication. So if you click on it, it shows me the teacher list with the subject name. And if you click on a particular teacher, see now second last teacher, Anina Mann, she has two communications for you. So if I click on it, it shows me what are the communications. So if I click on day 8 drama, so it shows me the communication detail. As a parent, you will be able to write and reply to her by updating your message here and sent. Or you can click on home button, or you can go back to a menu from here. Once you are finished, you can simply close the app and it will be closed. When the app is running in the background, it will also send you the push notification. Even if it is not connected it is not opened in the background, but your internet is on. In case of any difficulty, you can get in touch with school IT and we will be able to help you with any technical support required. Thank you for watching this video. Bye-bye.